Because it's taking the prices of value meals at fast food restaurants up.
CBS 8's Ariana Cohen is working for you. She went to some different fast food places here in San Diego.
Even in the best economy, the restaurant industry is all about struggle. Margins are incredibly tight, and even the slightest change in one statistic can make life miserable for the finest of establishments. Restaurants have been taken down by rising food prices, lower walk-in customers, government investigations, and fast food chains in particular have swung from huge revenues to near oblivion with shocking speed. Red Lobster, the 670-unit chain, has been hurt by high food and labor costs. It lost $15.3 million in the third quarter, well above the forecast of negative $10.4 million. Red Lobster has established itself as a famous seafood restaurant with multiple restaurants nationwide. The chain has provided delectable seafood meals for over 50 years and has proved itself to be one of the most well-known seafood restaurants in the country. The costs of running the restaurants, like paying their staff and other expenses, have been going up. A company called Thai Union Group bought Red Lobster in 2020 and is still trying to improve the menu to match changing tastes. However, around 100 Red Lobster locations are about to close because they're not making enough money, according to the company's executives. So Red Lobster is facing some serious financial challenges. Although they're trying to adapt to the changing market, it's not an easy task. Jack in the Box. This burger chain, founded back in 1951, has had its fair share of ups and downs. In the 1980s, it faced legal trouble for selling horse meat while claiming it was beef, which seriously hurt its reputation. Then in 1993, a major food poisoning outbreak linked to its restaurants made over 700 people sick, including 4 children. It was a near disaster for the company. However, they managed to bounce back in the early 2000s and regain popularity among American consumers. But lately, it's been facing a new set of challenges. The cost of meat has been going up, which is a big deal for a burger-focused chain. Also, fancier burger places like Shake Shack have been taking a bite out of their customer base. Moreover, people's eating habits are shifting, and fast food chains like Jack in the Box are having to adapt. Right now, they are in a tough spot. It's even on a watch list for possible bankruptcy, and Moody's, a credit rating agency, considers it one of the top 10 restaurant chains most at risk of going under in challenging times. Papa John's. This restaurant chain has had its share of troubles, especially with its founder and former CEO, John Schnatter. He made some controversial remarks about NFL players, which led to backlash and forced him to step down as CEO. Despite stepping down, Schnatter still owned a significant portion of the company. Things took a turn for the worse when Schnatter used a racial slur during a conference call. Although he resigned as chairman, he continued to try to regain control of Papa John's, which created turmoil within the company. This public feud caused Papa John's to lose important partnerships, including its deal as the official pizza of the NFL. To repair its tarnished image, Papa John's had to spend a substantial amount of money. However, the damage had already been done, and the company suffered significant financial losses. This turmoil led to Papa John's being replaced by Pizza Hut as the NFL's official pizza provider. Schnatter's ongoing attempts to regain control of the company, combined with public criticisms of the current leadership, continue to pose challenges for Papa John's. Buffalo Wild Wings. This restaurant is known for its lively atmosphere, sports, and delicious chicken wings. However, it has encountered several significant challenges. One of its major problems was a shortage of chicken wings and rising prices for wings, which they heavily rely on. This made it difficult for Buffalo Wild Wings to keep its prices competitive, and as a result, sales suffered. Additionally, Buffalo Wild Wings faced internal issues. They decided to increase menu prices, which further drove down sales at a time when competitors like McDonald's and KFC continued to offer wings at lower prices. To make matters worse, some customers complained that the quality of Buffalo Wild Wings food had declined. These factors combined to create a challenging environment for the restaurant. Buffalo Wild Wings finds itself in a downturn, and if they don't find effective solutions to these problems soon, it will continue to struggle in the coming months. Krispy Kreme. This is a famous donut shop liked by many. In 2022, Krispy Kreme had to take a tough step by closing down several of its underperforming stores to cut costs. While this move helped them save money in the short term, their overall financial performance was still disappointing. Recently, the CEO of Krispy Kreme, Michael J. Tattersfield, announced that they will need to lay off some employees. They also plan to increase automation in their stores to save on labor costs. These actions suggest that Krispy Kreme's financial problems are not going away anytime soon. The chain is facing a complex situation, and despite efforts to reduce its debt, it continues to face financial challenges. What lies ahead is still a mystery if they can't solve their financial problems. Boston Market. This is a restaurant known for its rotisserie chicken and convenient, ready-to-eat meals. It became quite popular after it started in 1990, but things changed over time. One major issue is increased competition. Other retailers started selling ready-to-eat rotisserie chicken, often at lower prices, which hurt Boston Market's business. To make matters worse, Boston Market had to file for bankruptcy due to financial difficulties. It was later bought by Sun Capital, but they've struggled to find a new competitive edge to attract customers. Another problem is the age of many Boston Market locations. Some of their stores are quite old and need costly renovations. The expense of these renovations will be challenging for the company, especially if some locations aren't doing well financially. As a result, the Boston Market is facing tough times. Their efforts to boost sales and adapt to changing consumer habits haven't yielded the desired results. CC's, a restaurant known for its unlimited pizza buffet, where customers can enjoy as much pizza as they want for a fixed price. However, in 2023, CC's is struggling to keep its doors open. The former CEO, Carl Wogla, pointed out a significant issue. CC's business model doesn't work as well as it used to. CC's relies on a high volume of customers to be profitable. However, in recent times, they haven't been attracting enough customers, which is crucial for covering rising costs such as labor and property taxes. To address these challenges, CC's tried implementing some new initiatives, like changing their logo, altering the menu, and adjusting the layout of their stores. Despite these efforts, it may not be enough to save the business. Moreover, CC's face increasing rent costs and minimum wage hikes, which add to their financial difficulties. Their number of restaurants has decreased, and it's uncertain whether they can navigate these tough times successfully. Crystal, a restaurant chain that has been serving burgers since 1932, gained popularity with its diverse menu, including signature items like garlic cheese toast, platters of fried shrimp, and an abundant salad bar. However, recent times have brought significant challenges. Crystal attempted an all-you-can-eat promotion, offering unlimited burgers and fries at a fixed price to attract more customers. Unfortunately, this strategy backfired and led to financial losses. Additionally, many Crystal restaurants are quite old and require expensive renovations. Renovations are costly, and it's unclear whether they can be completed given the financial health of the stores. As a result, Crystal finds itself in a difficult situation. Efforts to boost sales haven't yielded the desired results, and they face challenges both in terms of attracting customers and the costs associated with updating their aging locations. The road ahead is uncertain as they work to address these challenges in a competitive market. Quiznos, a sandwich chain that's been having a tough time lately for a while now. Franchise owners have been unhappy because they weren't making much money. One big problem was that Quiznos made them buy supplies at high prices, and this wasn't good for their profits. During this time, Quiznos was also trying to find a buyer. This created uncertainty, and they had to file for Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection. After that, a company called High Bluff bought Quiznos and reduced the number of Quiznos stores to just 800 worldwide. But even with these changes, Quiznos is still struggling. It's now competing with other popular sandwich places like Jersey Mike's, Firehouse Subs, Jimmy John's, and Subway. The big question is whether Quiznos will be able to make it through these tough times or not. It's in a highly competitive market, and nobody knows its future. Sonic Drive-In. Sonic is a fast food chain known for its drive-in service, where you can order food from your car. But Sonic has also been facing some problems. One issue is that when gas prices go up, fewer people visit Sonic. This is because when it costs more to fill up your car, you might not want to spend extra on eating out, even if it's convenient. On top of that, Sonic has some tough competition. Big names like McDonald's, Burger King, and Wendy's are in the same market, and that's not easy. Sonic has been making some changes to stay afloat. They sold some of their stores to franchise owners and bought back their stock. But beyond that, there haven't been many things boosting their bottom line. In the last 8 quarters, that's 2 years, Sonic has seen its sales decline. It won't take much more for Sonic Drive-In to run into more trouble in the coming months if things don't turn around. The challenges faced by many restaurant chains reflect the tough and competitive nature of the industry. Thin profit margins, rising costs, and changing consumer preferences can push even well-established brands into financial turmoil. As we navigate these uncertain times, it's a reminder that the restaurant landscape can change rapidly, and adaptability is key to survival. Careful planning and new ideas can still help these businesses stay in business. Comment down below on what you think, and leave a like if you find value in the content we do on this channel. Hit the subscribe button for all the latest updates, and we'll see you in the next video.